Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you two lapbook books I created using my own designed collections. One, it's vintage in green, it's this one that was first I created, and then I was put myself to some challenge. You know, I'm not using too much those bright colors, and especially pink, red I'm using, but pink and purple, I'm not using those colors too much. I don't feel very comfortable with them. I didn't feel very comfortable with them. So I tried to create my own design. It's in this book and it's totally inspired. I even put my nails for that book. It was kind of inspired my palette garden. Because I've got there is more red flowers, but also how I feel about perfumes. Lately, we spoke with my friend about perfumes. I had in the past my total favorite. It was from Avon, and I had their perfume I used on and on and on for many years. It was incandescent, I think, or iridescent, something like this. It was a small bottle. With gold lid, and that perfume was a really amazing perfume. But then they switch formula and I didn't like it. So I had to switch my perfume, and my sister have been using Davidoff, that cool water, for many years, and I love that perfume, but it wasn't my sense, it wasn't that I felt that way. But for last year he somehow changed. I think I a little bit grew up. My sister was always more mature. She was more calm and more grow up than I've been ever before. But probably I did grow up a little bit. I am still a teenager with many years of experiences. But I swapped to this perfume and I really like that. It smells so fresh, but still calm, and it has those small, I don't know how to explain it. It's like a very calm woman with very, very alive blood in vein. I feel that way about this perfume. So I'm using this perfume for now. And this was, I know this is in blue, but I feel about perfumes like they are from flowers. Even they are not, even they are using fruit, wood. So I feel about perfume like they are from flowers. For that was created this collection, that fuchsia color. And this was totally inspired by view of my window. I've got only green color. When I'm sitting in front of that window, let me move my camera. Here. This is view of from my window, what I see every day. So in that mood was created this collection, and I was kind of surprised myself how much I love green color. Even I didn't thought about that before. I think about green color that it's color of life, color of new life, color of nature, and I do love nature. If you saw any of my collections, even if is it that little red robin, that Christmas collection or this collection, most of these images are pretty close together because I don't like waste the paper. The paper, it's made from threes, and I do love threes. I always feel so, but if I do have so many offcuts, that's why I'm trying to use every single piece I do have around me. And in that way, I've got my collections that they are very close together, that if you will cut those images, you will have really just teeny, meeny, small pieces of cuts. You will don't waste your paper, because I will feel so bad. I will cry for those trees. Even when I've been small, my dad was, I'm gonna show you what is inside. I will don't explain, this is ephemera, this is stuck. You will see that, right? So I will talk. That's what I do. I do love talking. So when I've been small, my dad was like volunteer, those men who look after forests, those hunters, but they wasn't hunting all the time. There was hunting seasons when they was allowed to hunt. Some not separate, like choose animals, which was too much in that forest. But all the rest of the year, they look after forest, look after animals in that forest. They feed them, they clean fallen down trees, and we've been helping so much. I love that time. We always went to, I loved to go to forest with my dad at winter. It was so many snow in there. I am from Czech Republic, where normally when I've been small was winter very hard. We've been living under mountains, so there was always lots of snow. And I remember that sometimes I went behind my daddy and then poof, I dropped myself, or I felt myself through to that snow. So only maybe hat was seeing from my head, not me at all. So that had to dig into that snow to take me out from that snow many times. But I loved that time when we went to that forest and we went to help the animals. We went to feed them, to bring them nuts or dry grass, you know, all that food what they eat. And I remember one day we've been really very small with my sister, and one day we went to that forest close to our home, and there was like noisy, and our dad he shout on us, oh hey girls, come on, climb to the tree fast. And we didn't know why, but we did. We always did climb, love to climb on the trees. And that was fast right behind us, because there was, how to say, I know only pig, you know, that animal pig, which is not growing, which you have for a meal, but in the forest they are very fluffy, those wild pigs. I'm not sure if is it that right word, and they can be dangerous, especially if they are, oh, my English now will sound very terrible, if they are ladies, the pigs, fluffy pigs, I don't know how to say that, but where they are mommy, like where they've got their babies, they are very dangerous, really. They can kill you because they feel that they have to protect their babies, which what we did all. I can be that way as well if I do protect my babies. So we had to climb on the trees, and I remember I lost my doll. I always bring my dolls everywhere. And I lost my doll. And that wild pig, she grabbed that doll. And I start to cry. And she was right under that tree. And because I was crying, she didn't want to leave. And our dad was on that opposite tree. And he was shouting on me like, oh, please don't cry, don't cry. She will never leave. So I tried to calm myself and my sister, because she was always that calm person. So she tried to calm me down. She tried to tell me that, oh, I'm gonna buy you a new doll. And I told her that no, she was, you know, my dolls had always names, and she was Pippi. I remember that name. It was at the time when we was watching at the telly. There was a series, not Czech series. It was, I think, from Norway, about a girl. Her name was Pippi. She was ginger hairs, and her hair was in those ponytails, but the way around the head, like up around the head. She was so funny. She was riding white horse, and her dad was pirate, I think, if I remember that right. And that series was amazing. So one of my dolls, she had ginger hairs, and I remember I called her Pippi. And that Pippi fell down, and that wild pig, she was picking up, and she destroyed my Pippi. But I remember that time when we went with our dad to that forest to help those animals. That was so much to joy. That was so many, adventures. We build up in the summer. We build up like small cities from the branches falling down from the trees, around the trees, like small fences and small houses. It was so amazing, and my dad always taught us how to build those things, how to make a whistle. Is it the right word for from the branch? You will cut a piece, you will make a hole through to that, and you can play on that. I'm not sure if it's a whistle, but he taught us this one as well. So it was amazing time. So all this, even it was inspired by my view from my window. All this brings so many memories, really so many memories. And I remember I'm back in with that mushroom collection every year, every single year, many times in the summer. We went to go to forest to find the mushrooms because they are very tasty. If you know which kind of you can pick up, they are very tasty and they are amazing. And my grandma, she always went to the forest for herbals. She was a really good one in herbals. She knew so much things about herbals. My daddy's mom, she was amazing. So all those memories, they are, you know, that when I created this one, that was like go in the past, go through the past and remember. And in that forest where we went to help to animals and where we went to help to our dad to look after those animals and look after those trees, there was also like camp. Children's camp, and that it's like a game in my country. When you got somewhere, it's like pioneer camp, right? It was at the past, and I'm not sure if pioneers are still there. I don't think that pioneers are still there. There are scouts now, but it was the time when it was pioneers, and in that forest was one pioneer camp, and every summer there was children camping, and I remember we village kids we did those missions through the night, only kids, and that was safe time when you like a kid can go out even through the night because there wasn't any creepy people who can kill you. Now it's so weird because there is so many dangerous things, but when I've been small, that was like safe place, you know. We was able to go about midnight to go to that forest, and we had pretty good time. No one was scared like someone will kill us or so. And we made every single summer, we made missions, like we village kids, we made missions to steal a flag from those camps. That was pretty good. Really, that was so amazing, so exciting. And I remember even those kids, they did in those camps, they did enjoy it because they knew that we will come in one night. So they had to watch the flag of that pioneer camp. They had to watch that they had night guards. I can't see green, so I'm thinking about garden. But they had night guards who were supposed to watch all camp and also that camp flag. And we did impossible things to steal that. It was so amazing. That's why all we, all our kids' family, we knew how to climb the trees. We knew how to say that. You know, when a snake walks, he doesn't walk, you know, but when he moves on the floor, on the ground, he moves like this. So we copied that, you know, to be hide in the grass. I don't know how to say that. What snakes do? How is that right word? I don't remember. I don't even never look for that because I never need to know how is that right word. When snake walk or move, not walk. When snake move, he does that laying down on the ground and moving. So we did this one to get to that pillar with that flag. I don't think I've got something here, but here I've got another, those images. And it was really amazing. It was so exciting. And we always celebrated when we've been successful. When we wasn't successful, we tried that next night again and again. Sometimes when it was after rain. And we tried to do that snakes on the ground. And we came home really dirty from everything we went through. I remember my mom was, whoa, that was very painful. That was very painful. That was not too good. We've been punished so hard, you know. Or when we spent too long time in that forest and we came after midnight. Oh, even my dad, he was very, very mad on us. So he was like, never again, girls. So, but that time was so exciting, really. That was proper childhood. When I see those kids now, sometimes I feel so sorry for them because they don't have this excitement anymore, I think. There is too much dangerous time, too many weird people. I don't know. I think those kids are missing so much, really. Those missions was totally amazing. So when I created, especially this one, that was bring me so much joy. I don't have anything here. Okay. And all that green I see through that window every single summer. Especially when I leave. If you notice, I've got around my window that ivy leaves. All my wall around the window, it's covered with that ivy leaves. And I love that, but I can't leave it there. Because it will ruin the house. So I will have to take it off. I do it every year, but more and more I'm taking time to do it. To keep that greenery around for a little bit longer time. Because I do love nature. I do, really. So all this creation, it's like, go in the past. And this is magnetic. Here is magnet and here is magnet. So I'm going through to that lapbook. As you can see, it has many openings. It has so much stuff. And most of them are my design. And those small tags and tickets, they are actually offcuts from all that rest. So I tried to spend everything I had, really. So it has many pockets, many openings. Not too hard openings, because this is supposed to be very understandable setup of book. That was tutorial for my Patreon. So if you would like to do book like this, don't be afraid to go to that Patreon page, because you can sign up just for 1 month, pick up all kind of tutorials I've got already there, or pick up all kind of images I got already there, download it to your computer, and then sign off there. You know, I'm not gonna force you to stay there. I will appreciate every single one. I hope my Patreons know that, how much I love them, how much I appreciate them. They are very patient with me. They are, really. They are amazing. They are very patient. I adore them so much. So this was one of tutorials I tried. I tried to do on my Patreon page. And I always do appreciate every your support here on YouTube, all messages I get. I know I am very terrible with answering all those messages. It's taking time for me. But it's sometimes, you know, I never used a book. I forgot something here. Okay. I never used a book for learning English. Maybe it's wrong. I guess that's wrong, but I mostly learn from my colleagues at work, what they are saying. I tried to find what that means, like guessing. And maybe it's wrong that I never used a book, because then that writing takes a time for me. It was like when I had that video with perforated envelope. If you saw that video with that vintage perforated video. Oh gosh, with that vintage perforated envelope, there was mining, was that right word? And I said meaning, because for me it was M. Oh, that was somehow different, say. Not probably mining. And was M A? No, M I? M I N I. When I see this, for me, it's like logical that both I will say same. But English language, it's so hard, because exactly for this one, even you've got M-I-N-I writing down, you are saying that first I a little bit different way, even if it's the same letter, you know what I mean? You've got different pronunciation of letters, even they are wrote exactly like, you know, same way, you know. It's hard to explain. And I just found that this key fell down from something. I will have to find where. So this collection was totally inspired all those perfumes, because I think about perfumes that way, that they are colorful. Some of them, they are very heavy. Some of them, they are very soft. But most of them, they used flowers or a scent of flowers. So this was pretty inspired by perfumes. And for a long time I wasn't sure about this collection, but more and more I'm looking on that collection. I think I'm turning finally to a proper woman back again. My son doesn't need tough women around them anymore. They are old enough to look after themselves. So I guess I don't have to be that tough mom anymore, who will be not ill because kids need her, who will have all the time. Oh, why is falling down? Aha, look, I know. I will have to use another jump rings. These are not too strong, so I will have to fit those two charms again. You know, I don't have to be again anymore that tough woman who can survive anything and everything, because my sons are already grown men. They can look after themselves. So I can start to be woman, proper woman, with all kind of, even if I am ill, I am just ill, I am human only. But when you are single mom, you just can't do this. You can't be ill, you know, because kids needs you, and who will look after kids if you will be ill, right? You can't cry, because then kids will feel not safe. They will feel something happening. So you can't cry. So many times people around me was thinking, oh, she's too tough. I am in some points of life. I am maybe tougher than other ladies. But it's just because life taught me that way. Those things which was happened to me, sometimes they was my mistake, my wrong choices. But the life just taught me to be tough and to be hard. So I'm not always sweet. Don't think about me that way. I'm not always sweet. If something it's not good to me, if something try to be bad to me, fake, wrong, I am turning to bad persons. Not bad like I will do something bad, but I'm not letting people to deal with me really bad way, like I will be just shut up. No. If someone is not fair to me, if someone try to use my goodwill, someone try to use me for their own profit, and they just think that I can't be used, I'm not allowing people to do that. It's just too bad, because I don't do that to people, you know? So, yeah. And probably that's why people thought about me that I am a tough woman. But I don't think about myself that way. I think I am soft woman. Even I had to hide it for many years. I had to hide it that I am a soft woman. I had to be stronger than I actually was. I had to be stronger for my boys, for to make them safe, to make them feel safe, that nothing will happen, you know. It have to be done for kids. If you are a single parent, no matter what, if you are a single dad, you have to be sometimes softer than men can be. Manly audience, if you know what I mean. Not men like human, but men like, you know, that opposite of female. They have to be softer sometimes, even they don't want to be. But if they are single parents, they have to show that mom inside of them for their kids, you know. So that was same with me. Sometimes I had to show that even it's not good, I have to be that stronger person here now. I have to teach my son how to use hammer. That wasn't a never problem for me, because my dad taught me this one when I was very young. He taught us how to cut. Is it right word? How to cut trees using ace, using saw. Is it right word? Saw. That electric saw, any kind of tool. So I've been pretty good with any kind of tool since I've been small. Everything falling down. Oops. So you can just have a look. I'm gonna find that ticket. Where is it? So to teach my boys how to use hammer or ace or saw, that wasn't bad. But to learn myself how to be not like mommy. Not like, oh, my babies, if you know what I mean. That was always so hard for me, really. Really. That was very, very hard for me to learn myself how to bring a little bit of manly thinking, manly logic to my family when my sons was grow up mostly just with me. And I can say that I wasn't being too successful with that. Because to be tough like men, it's not easy. They do think totally different way. They do think about things, about time in life, totally different way. And to try to copy that, I can't. I can't. They think, oh, if he will hurt himself, that's his fault. But me, like a mom, I'm thinking, he can't hurt himself. I have to help him, you know, I have to protect him. And to try to find some compromise of this one, of this confusion. That was always so hard. So what you see here, they are mostly my design. Those photographs, they are definitely not my design. And I'm mumbling about everything. I think I will start to talk about that journal again. Yeah, as you can see, it has so much flower design, so much pink and like fuchsia colors, so many butterflies, very soft butterflies. And I can see more and more. I'm looking on this collection. Maybe I finally feel like a woman back again. I think I need it. I think I need to put some softness to my life. Yeah, I'm gonna show you this way. Something more like I'm expecting to open doors from a man because he is gentleman, you know. I never expect that before, but I think it's right. Because me, as a woman, I will be soft, and he, like a man, he will be the tough. Right? That's the change of that very, very interesting book. That's the secret. I know that book is not writing about this one, but I took it from there, you know. It's about expression, how you will feel about that. what you will take from books, not what you will, that you will have to follow those books. And I think I already put that video with the part when I am talking about this one. When I'm reading books, any kind of books, it doesn't mean that I will follow them unless it's mathematic book or instruction how to put together wardrobe, right? That is very helpful to follow step by step everything what is write down. But the rest, it's about applying to your life, not about following every single step. You have to apply something what you will choose, you like. You have to apply it to your life. Do not follow step by step. And I think this video, it's already too long, so I'm going faster. So as you can see, it has many openings, many pockets. It has really many images. I'm going faster. I'm not going to talk anymore. Ooh. I've been today on coffee with my best friend, and I already talked 3 hours of women talk, because we need it both. And we talk mostly about men. That's so strange that we always end up with, we start about kids, then we go shopping, then we go on coffee, then we talk about, you know, that. Some women talk, and we always ending talking about men. I'm not sure if men has same problem. They do talk about women all the time. I am really not sure. I have to ask my boys what they do talk about. Here we've got writing section, and as you can see, I used also that very soft design on those papers, those journaling papers, and they do have bullet journal papers. I made them myself. It's designed like this, with that bullet journal. That dip, dot, dot, dot. So it has those tickets again. I'm going to be a little bit faster, because I'm talking too much, and you can't see. You can, but I think it's just too much to listen to me mumbling. So I will appreciate if you will let me know what kind of perfume you like. Maybe I will choose some, you know, some new one. I'm not sure. But I really like all those. I don't like those very heavy perfumes. Not those deep, heavy perfumes. I don't like them. For me, it's no good. They make me choke. Is that right word? Choke. But I do like all those fresh perfumes. I do like perfumes with cedar wood. I do love perfumes with fuchsia smell, but I don't know which perfume has fuchsia. I will have to Google it, because I love fuchsia flowers. They are gorgeous flowers with beautiful smell. So if you will let me know what perfume you like, I will appreciate that, really. I think it's always good to know some good perfumes, because we always use them. So I will appreciate some good advices. What perfume is good for you? What perfume do you use? If you use any. Like my mom, she has, I think, 3 different perfumes. One she used for every day, another one she used when she's going to the cinema or theater. You know, it's a little bit heavier. And another perfume she has when she's sad. She's got special perfume when she feels sad, because she always saying that perfume makes her happy. So I told her a few times. One time. I tried that one just one time, and she've got a really good explanation, so I stopped asking. Because she was like, aha, I do understand now. I asked her why she doesn't use that perfume all the time, you know, that will be make you happy, so you will be happy every day. And she told me, yeah, if I will use it every day, that happy feeling will go away, and I will don't feel happy anymore with that perfume. That's why I'm saving it. When I feel sad, I'm going to use that perfume, because I know it will work. And I think it's very logical. If you've got something, if you are happy all the time, if you don't have any struggle in your life, you will don't feel that way. You will don't appreciate that happy time, right? So I do understand, because you will don't see that you are actually happy. You will don't have that hard time, which we'll show you now. It's that hard time. So when you will be happy, you will feel that way. If you will be without any problems all the time, so you can't imagine, you can actually feel happy, you know, you can appreciate that it's now happy time, enjoy it, because then they will be tough days. I'm so wondering where I will have those no problemy days, because I do have always, all the time, I do have some issues. It's like I'm calling them. It's like now, Evie, you have to enjoy it. So here, this, and we are on the end, yay, with my talking. So these are my two Lapbooks using my own designed papers. If you like those papers, they are on my Etsy. I will put link down below to give you you know, quick direction where to find those papers if you like them. If you like those Lapbooks, you can find the tutorial on my Patreon. You don't have to be scared to go there. You can sign up just for 1 month to pick up this tutorial or all those tutorials I've got there. And it has also pocket here. It's empty, and this one has pocket here as well. And I guess here, yeah, here I've got many other. Here I've got that rest. Oops, I totally forgot. Here I've got that rest. So you can pick up just tutorials, or you can pick up all those images I've got there, all those ephemeras, all those collections I shared there already, and just you know, signed out. It's no pressure on you at all. So, and here I just coffee dyed papers. Oh my, this video is very long. I'm going to fix those two embellishments, those two charms, where they fall down. I'm going to use some different rings, those rings, because they are not strong enough to hold those cards. So this is my sharing for today. I hope you enjoyed to watch all those openings, all those pictures and ephemeras. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. Thank you so much for all your amazing support. I hope you know how much I appreciate that, how wonderful day I always have when you're leaving those amazing comments to me. And if you would like to see something, please leave me comment what you would like to see, and I will try to do my best to bring video with anything you would like to see. Thank you so much for spending your time with me today. Take care about yourself, and see you next time. Bye.